is Ruth Silverman for IronManMagazine.com, here to talk about the gals, the pretty girls, the figure girls, the bikini girls. We're talking about the Olympia coming up September 24th and 25th at the Orleans Hotel in Las Vegas. Lots of talk about a lot of gals. We'll go to figure first because that is sort of the known quantity. The big question, can Erin Sturm or anyone overtake Nicole Wilkins-Lee? Two very different styles. Nicole won the Olympia last year. She won the Arnold Classic as well, with Erin coming in second. Can Erin overtake her? A lot of people think Erin's got the body to beat. I say that may be so, but it's an apples and oranges situation. I say the judges are going to pick Nicole again. She's a beautiful girl, blonde, still in her early 20s, gets more glamorous every time I see her. And when I did see her at the USA a few weeks ago, she told me she's not letting go of that title. So I have a feeling everybody else had better bring it. In second, I'm picking Erin Sturm. Gorgeous girl, very classy look, taller, nice, beautifully proportioned body, fair amount of muscle, just because she's got a very athletic body. She's a track star. I say she'll come in second here. I say third will be Heather Mae French. They will come in the same way they did at the Arnold Classic at the Miss Fitness Figure International this year. They'll be first, Nicole first, Erin second, and Heather Mae third. In fact, I'm basically predicting that the top six in the Olympia were going to be very similar to last year. Only difference, Erin was third. I say she will be moving up to second in that spot that has been vacated by Gina Aliotti, who is not doing the contest this year. And then the rest will be pretty much the way it fell. As I say, Nicole first, Erin third, Heather Mae fourth. Heather Mae third. That would put fourth Crystal Richardson again. Now, she was out of the running in March in the international. She had to stay out of the show, but she'll be back. I know she's training hard, and I'm pretty sure she'll take at least that fourth spot again. In fifth, Pittsburgh girl Amy Fry, homegirl. Amy's been a top fiver ever since she got into the Olympia, and I think she will hold that position here. Six, I'm picking a newcomer, Cheryl Brown. Now, Miss Cheryl, she's had a sensational career since turning pro in the middle of last summer. She has come in second, she's come in third, she finally won a show. Well, she won a show last fall, actually. I say she will be the one to take that number six spot. Something I want to say about this show, there are 27, count them, 27 women going to be in this lineup unless somebody drops out. And that means that 17 women are not going to make the top 10. And some of them are going to be people who did very well over the year. Some of the gals who won contests this year who I've not included in the top six, Candace Keene, Felicia Romero, Mindy Smith, and Terry Turner. These are all good competitors, and they all could do it. They could do it. I particularly like Terry Turner's physique. She's really balanced, doesn't have those big shoulders that so many of the competitors have that I think really throws off. Mindy Smith is a question mark, did fabulous, you know, won her first show, won the Nationals last year, won the first show of the season in Arizona, got to the Arnold Classic, the Fitness Figure International, got fourth there, then had some disappointing showings later in the year. So whether she'll make the top six, that's a question. Another person I'm thinking could definitely worm her way into the top six is Larissa Reyes, Brazilian gal. Everybody loves this girl's look. She really has sex appeal beyond pretty much everyone on the stage. Very easy for her to slip into the top six as well. As for Felicia Romero, she's won a couple shows. She was top five at the international. But I got to say, it'll depend on whether we see the Felicia who was at the Olympia and who won the border stage show last fall. If we see the Felicia that we saw in March, I think she'll have a hard time making this. She was not in shape. I think she'll have a hard time making the top six. So anyway, 27 are coming. Only six can get qualified for the Olympia next year. Who will it be? Who will be left out? I don't know, but that's it for the figure. On to bikini. Oh my, new sport, new girls, anything can happen. The question, mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the sassiest of them all? In other words, so many divas in one short year, so little time, but let's talk about them. The year in bikini. We started the year, Sonia Gonzalez won the first two shows. Then came the first new diva, that would be Nathalia Mello. She came in, beat Sonia, won two shows. Then we had our next diva, Nicole Negreanu. Another one does one or two amateur shows, comes in, wins a pro show right away. This is another hot babe, as we say. Well, all the bikini girls are hot babes, and we mean that in the nicest way. After Nicole, she won her show, The Tampa Pro. Then we had Allie Rosen. Wins the USA, gets her pro card, immediately goes to Jacksonville the next week, wins her first show, then comes in second at the Super Show the year after. How do I think it's going to fall? Well, an interesting... Oh, then at the Super Show, we have Amanda Latona. Third earlier in the year, comes in, sees that Nathalia Mello is not on her game. This would be at the Dallas Super Show a couple weeks ago. Next thing you know, Amanda has roared her chassis into first place, with Allie Rosen in second, leaving Nathalia to come in third in that lineup. Before that show is pretty much a foregone conclusion that Nathalia Mello was going to be the first Bikini Olympia champ. Why? Because judges were saying that she had the body, she had the model for the body that they were looking for in bikini. Then later in the year, she comes, gets third. I say, so she had a bad day. My guess, Nathalia will be the winner of the first bikini. A little flub, but I see her winning the show. In second, I'm going to surprise you. Most people are thinking I'm going to pick Amanda Latona, another Pittsburgh girl, I might add. But I think our Southern California Sonia Gonzalez, who got out-sassed in Pittsburgh, is going to be the sassiest gal on stage. She's been hanging around a lot with Adela Garcia, and if anyone could teach her how to sass it up on stage, it would be the number one chica, Adela. So I'm taking a leap here and going with Sonia for second, Amanda Latona, who still is one hot babe, coming for third. Think about bikini. It's not about what they look in the still shots. You gotta see them moving. It's how they sassy the chassis. And these girls, the best way to do that, if you can only look at pictures, go to one of the websites that has all the pictures from a show. If they've got a slideshow mechanism, do it, because it makes it look like the girls are moving. You get an idea of how they move on stage. So that would be your top three there. Go for fourth, I'm going for the number two diva of the year, Nicole Negrani from Florida, as is Nathalia Mello. I think this girl will make the fourth call, and she will get it, you know, she'll do very well. For fifth, I'm going out on a limb. Allie Rosen, the third or fourth sensation of the summer, once again won the USA, came in and won a pro show the next year, then got second at the Super Show. The question with Allie is she really a contender here, or was she just the flavor of the month? I'm saying she'll be good enough for fifth. And in sixth, I'm picking Jamie Baird. This is a great competitor. She was one of the hottest young gals to get her pro card in bikini. We waited a long time for her to make her stand. She has done well in every show she's been in, but every single one of these gals has beaten her, so I'm thinking she's going to finish sixth in this lineup. 19 gals will be coming to Las Vegas to strut their stuff in the first Bikini Olympia. I can't wait to see what happens. So there you have it, figure bikini for the Olympia. The Bikini Olympia will be held on September 24th at the Orleans Hotel. The figure Olympia will be held judging on the 24th, and then the finals will be on the 25th at night with the Mr. Olympia finals. I'm very excited. I hope you are too. I'll see you in Vegas. This is Ruth Silverman for IronManMagazine.com, and I'm done here.